Hello and welcome to the channel Automation Step by Step. I'm Raghav and you are watching QnA Friday. So let us begin our today QnA Friday episode. And today we are going to take up a question asked by Zafar. And he says, how to decide which type of testing is required for a project, when to do manual testing and when to do automation testing. Zafar, thank you so much for asking this question. And this is a very relevant question today. In a lot of organizations and in a lot of projects, we always have this question, what to automate, when to automate and how to automate. So today we will focus on what to automate. So whenever you have an application and you have your testing, you always run some feasibility analysis, or there are some checkpoints that you go through to analyze and to evaluate whether your application is a good candidate or feasible for automation or not. Now, some of these criteria are, the first one is we always check whether the application is stable or not. So in case your application is under development stages and it is changing very frequently, every second or third day we have a new code base and there are a lot of changes in your application, then of course we might not want to go with automation, because in case you do automation parallelly, then you might have to do a lot of rework and you might have to do a lot of changes with every build. So we always, most of the time, say that the application should be stable. Now, there are some organizations who start automation along with development, so that by the time development is over, we have a stable automation framework and we also have automation script, so that we can start automation right away. Now, this approach also works in some cases, but most of the times we say that the application should be stable enough for automation to take place. The second thing is we check whether manual testing is highly repeatable. So in case you are doing some manual testing and you have some scenarios which are highly repeatable, for example, you have a test case where you fill a form on a website and it has like 100 fields and you do the same kind of actions on every test, on every build, then these kind of highly repeatable tasks are very good candidates for automation. The third one is, we always check whether the test cases or the scenarios are feasible for automation. There is a term called as automation gating criteria. Now, the automation gating criteria is actually a list of some checkpoints that we run on the application or on the manual test cases to check whether these test cases or the steps inside the test cases are good candidate for automation. I will have a separate session where I will discuss about the checkpoints on automation gating criteria. The fourth one is, we always check that the automation that we do or the scripts, automation scripts that we will create, that will be useful for a long duration of times. So it should not be like we invest so much time in creating automation frameworks, in creating automation scripts, and they are just used for a month and are not usable after that. So of course, we always check whether the automation that we are going to create is going to be useful and helpful for a long duration. And then the fifth thing is the time and skills required. We always evaluate the time required for automation and the skills that will be required for automation, so that we always go ahead and create a very good and stable automation framework and platform. And the sixth thing is ROI, which is return of investment. So whenever we decide on automation, we always do this analysis, that what will be the cost, effort and time required for automation, and then what will we get out of it after automation is done. For example, I invest X in creating the automation framework and creating the scripts, and all the investment that I do is X. Then after automation is done, what I get back should be X plus Y. In case I'm getting back only X or X minus Y, then probably I should not go for automation. So these are some of the criteria, these are some of the checkpoints or evaluation things that we do before deciding whether to automate or not. And in most of the organization, I see that there are a mix and match of automation and manual testing, where most of the repeatable things are automated and some things are still kept manual. There are some other organizations where most of the things are automated and only very few test cases are left for manual testing. So this is how we decide whether to go for automation testing or manual testing. I hope this session was useful for you. In case you want to feature your question in the next episode of Q&A Friday, do send me your query along with your name and location at ask.qnafriday@gmail.com. Thank you for watching.